The Garofalo said that no Garofalo should ever set foot in the deep, dark woods.
Why not? Why not?
Because if you do, the big bad mouse will be after you. I met him once, said the Garofalo. I met him a long, long time.
What does he look like? Tell us, Dad! Is he terribly bad? And terribly bad!
I can't quite remember, the Garofalo said. Then he thought for a minute and scratched his head. The big bad mouse is terrible. And his scaly tail is terribly long. His eyes are like pools of terrible fire. And his terrible whiskers are tougher than wire. One night, when the Garofalo snored, the Garofalo's child was feeling bored. The Garofalo's child was feeling brave. So, she tiptoed out of the Garofalo cave. The snow fell fast and the wind blew wild. Into the wood went the Garofalo's child. Aha! Oh ho! A trail in the snow! Whose is this trail? And where does it go? A tail poked out of a log pile house. Could this be the tail of a big bad mouse?
How is the creature?
Oh, one eyelid. Alex.
One eye. Oh.
And he didn't have whiskers. No, none at all.
You're not the mouse.
Not I, said the snake. He's down by the lake. He's in Garofalo cave. The snow fell fast and the wind blew wild.
I'm not scared,
said the Garofalo child. Aha! Oh ho! Marks in the snow. Whose are these claw marks? Where do they go? Two eyes gleamed out of a treetop house. Could these be the eyes of the big bad mouse? Down flew the creature. His tail was short, and he didn't have whiskers of any sort. You're not the mouse! Woo-hoo! Got high! But he's somewhere nearby! He's in Garofalo Pie! The snow fell fast and the wind blew wild.
I'm not scared, said the Garofalo's child.
Aha! Oh ho! A track in the snow. Whose is this track? And where does it go? Whiskers at last. And an underground house. Could this be the home of the big bad man? Harry? You're not the mouse.
Oh, no. Not me. He's under a tree, drinking garofalo tea.
It's all a trick,
said the Gruffalo's child, as she sat on a stump where the snow lay piled.
I don't believe in the big bad mouse.
What? Here comes a little one.
Out of his house!
Not big, not bad, but a mouse at least. You'll taste good as a midnight feast!
Wait! Said the mouse, before you eat, there's a friend of mine who you ought to meet. If you let me hop onto a hazel twig, I'll make him a friend so bad and big.
The Gruffalo's child unclenched his fist.
The big bad mouse, so he does exist.
The mouse hopped onto a hazel tree. He beckoned, then said,
"Just wait and see."
Out came the moon. It was bright and round.
A terrible shadow fell onto the ground.
Who is this creature so big, bad and strong? His tail and his whiskers are terribly long. His ears are enormous, and over his shoulder he carries a nut as big as a boulder. The big bad mouse!
Yelled the Gruffalo's child. The mouse jumped down from the twig and smiled. Prints in the snow. Whose are these footprints? Where do they go? The footprints led to the Gruffalo. Where the Gruffalo's child was a bit less brave. The Gruffalo's child was a bit less bored. And the Gruffalo snored. And snored. And snored. Thank you.